Empathy is an umbrella term for those different abilities to both share, but also to understand what other people feel. Our collective empathy is like the psychological equivalent of a natural resource, and it is a precious one. Decades of evidence suggest that empathy helps all sorts of people, including the people who feel it. So folks who are high versus low in empathy tend to be less depressed and lonely. Teenagers who are able to pinpoint the emotions of their peers are better able to survive the slings and arrows of seventh grade. And empathy tracks professional success at both the individual and organizational level. Empathy's benefits ripple outward. Patients of empathic doctors are more satisfied with their care and more likely to follow medical recommendations. Employees of empathic managers call in sick less often with stress-related illnesses. And maybe unsurprisingly to some of you, spouses of empathic partners tend to be happier in their marriage. Empathy also benefits broader communities. Empathic people tend to be sort of kind towards strangers, for instance, donating to charity or volunteering. And even inspiring someone to feel empathy for just a moment makes it more likely that they'll step in to help a stranger. Empathy tracks greater open-mindedness, for instance, decreases in stereotyping and prejudice. And finally, empathy tracks interest in environmental sustainability, a crucial need for our time. So we're doing great so far. Congratulations, everybody. We've got empathy on our side, this ancient, instinctive, powerful engine for kindness. I guess we'll all just be the nicest people that we can from now till eternity. Wait a minute, no, of course it's not that simple. Empathy can be hard. And to understand why, let's revisit our Paleolithic pals here and think about the world in which human empathy evolved. What was social life like for these people? Well, they existed mostly in tiny bands of hunter-gatherers, just a few families apiece. What that meant is that if you were hanging out 60,000 years ago and you ran into another person, several things were probably true. They were probably similar to you and maybe even related to you. You probably had known each other maybe your whole lives. You were visible to each other, right? So you could see pain and pleasure on each other's face and hear it in each other's voices. And you were accountable to each other, meaning that people knew each other's history of kindness and cruelty and could reward or punish them accordingly. In other words, karma was real, direct, and unavoidable. These ingredients are what I would call empathy's primordial soup, packed with ingredients that make it easy and natural for us to care for and help each other. But I would also argue that these same facets of social life are increasingly disappearing among our modern context, because life is nothing like what it was back then. In 2007, humanity crossed a remarkable line. For the first time ever, more people lived inside cities than outside of them. This is an accelerating trend, such that in 1950, one-third of humanity was urban, but by 2050, that number will be two-thirds. In other words, whereas the average person a few decades ago might have woken up in a place like this, maybe a small town where they knew everyone and everyone knew them, nowadays, and especially into the future, most of us will wake up in places like these, megalopoli, where we're surrounded by millions of neighbors. But being surrounded by people isn't the same as knowing them, because the rise in urban living has been accompanied by an equally rapid rise in solitary living. More people live alone than ever before, and that's especially true in cities and of younger people. In the US, 18 to 34-year-olds are 10 times more likely to live alone than they were just a century ago. And even the rituals that used to bring us into regular contact, everything from bowling leagues to church going to even grocery shopping, have given way to more solitary pursuits, often carried out online. So what that means is that more than ever, humanity is alone in a crowd. We see more people than we ever did before, but we know fewer of them. And when we do encounter each other, it's often in cases where we're anonymous, thinned out, and transactional. This is not great soil for empathy, and there are lots of ways in which empathy fails among our modern world.